I'll equate flying an airplane on a combat mission to playing a musical instrument. It's important that your fingers hit the right keys in the right order, just as it is in an airplane, that your fingers hit the right buttons in the right sequence. So you practice that. Then when you put 4 Gs on the airplane and your hand weighs more and you're trying to look back over your shoulder and you still have to play the piano, it's important that you do this sort of training under stress, under G.
ETC has always been in the field of aviation medicine, and we've always been concerned about how the pilot responds to the flight environment. Really, in the case of tactical flight simulation, it was a dream that goes back 30 plus years. I guess I never had any doubt that what we're doing was achievable. And so we began our quest, and as the new technologies rolled in, we were continually able to embrace those new technologies and incorporate them.
The thing that I see very clearly, the principle that I think is going to be important over the coming decades, is that the F-22 and the F-35 for the Air Force, all of these jets are going to be able to pull a lot of Gs. And you don't want to put a pilot in the airplane who is not capable of flying a jet through its full performance envelope.
Static simulators just will not cut it anymore.
There's motion cueing in aircraft simulation, and there's also real motion, G on demand motion.
We need to have pilots experience Gs, not just to have a fixed simulator, task trainer, in other words, to keep current with the switches. The ATFS-400 brings it right to the latest state-of-the-art capability with advanced visuals linked to the G-vector. That's a scientific breakthrough that's now been engineered and delivered and can be flown by pilots.
The machine will lead to readiness. Several flights in ATFS-400 in the transition stage between aircraft would have saved a considerable number of dollars in flying hour and a considerable amount of wing life under high G environment.
So this is really the next step. This is as much as the F-35 or the F-22 have advanced technology, this is advanced simulation technology.
I look at this as real physics. The beauty of that kind of an approach is that you can build your whole syllabus of physiologic training right into a realistic aviation experience pulling Gs. And that's what I sensed when I flew.
This device demonstrates very clearly that tactical flight simulation can be achieved in a dynamic environment.
People need to get into ATFS-400 and fly it and feel the profile to know how far ETC has taken centrifuge technology.